What's up, everybody? Today we're going to be taking a look at schema markup and how to do an audit. Now there's three ways that you could do it. I'm going to show you the free way, although it is a manual way. It is slow, it's kind of clunky at times, but you could use Screaming Frog, which is the way that I would typically do for the agency. You could use Ahrefs and SEMrush. Both are also third-party tools that would allow you to kind of do this at scale. I don't think that they're as proficient of a tool as Screaming Frog, but if you already have them, then why not use them? But let's begin. So we're going to be taking a look at a website called The Ordinary, and I just have it open in SEMrush, and we can see that this website is very large. They generate about 2.3 million views per month. You can see this highlighted right here. So it's a massive website. And when I pulled up the structured data for one of the products that was highlighted on their homepage, a gift set, the most loved set, it's a mini collection of some of our most loved products. I just kind of wanted to take a look at how they were doing structured data. And it was actually kind of surprising because while they're doing product schema correctly, they have their offer in here so that on the SERP itself, they're going to be showing the price available. They have their aggregate rating, so they'll have the stars previewed, and I'll go over this in the rich results test. They have their review types in here, but I also noticed that they're missing a lot of the typical schema markups that you would typically see on a website, your web page, your website, your organization. And just quickly looking over here, they have breadcrumbs, so they're missing out on breadcrumbs as well. They have a return policy, so they're missing out on any kind of returns type schema. They have about usage. So how to use, they could be using how to schema. So there are a bunch of different ways that they could be implementing other structured datas in order to really kind of give Google a better idea of what's on this page and what it's about. Down here, we have another section on other products that are related to this. And in this instance, you could use the related schema to show like this product is related to this one. And so Google would be able to recognize that as well. Now, if you're new to structured data, I don't expect you to understand all of these different product types. Schema properties and schema types right off the bat. So we're just going to hop over to ChatGPT. And if you don't pay for ChatGPT, that's perfectly fine. 3.5 will work for this. I've created prompt personas. They're totally free to use. I'll drop a link in the description below. And you can just simply copy and paste. I've created one for digital marketing. So just copy this and paste it into ChatGPT, which is exactly what you're seeing here. And I've also selected 3.5. So again, this is a totally free method. And I'm just simply going to ask ChatGPT to kind of relay all the different types of schema that would be appropriate for a product page. If I could actually type that out. And what this is going to do is probably give us a whole general list of different types. And it's a really great place to start if you're just starting out. Because while there is the schema database and you can kind of comb through it, anybody that has tried to comb through it is going to tell you it's really difficult to actually look at and kind of parse the data because they do not make it in a way that's easy to digest. So let's take a look at here. Product type, they're telling you to include name, description, image, product identifier. Yeah, this is all great. Your SKU, your GTIN, if you do have one available. Offers, which we saw earlier, aggregate rating, brand information, your manufacturing. Yeah, this is great. Now let's just simply ask it for even more types. All right, and now this is what I was actually expecting to see. So we have the organization schema, And again, for a website that's as big as The Ordinary, really 2.3 million visitors a month is large. That would be by far the largest client that I have. For them to not have organization schema, it's notable. Website schema, yeah, I would expect to see that. Breadcrumb schema, again, they already have the breadcrumb here. That's not too much of an uplift for them to include that. Article schema, that's not really appropriate for this page. Review, they've included video schema. That would be great, you know, maybe if they included a video demonstrating how to actually apply this product to your face, you know, going through the whole process of applying it and then removing it, or, you know, talking a little bit more about what's in the product. But just going through it, I don't think that they have that available. No, they don't. But that would be a great one. FAQs, you know, if you have FAQs about your product, that's a great way. Now, there's been some kind of commotion about whether they've been depreciated, because Google has kind of raised that they're going to be not putting a focus on those going into the future because of the rise of AI on the SERP. But I still recommend companies use FAQs. I think that they're really helpful, even if they are not going to be as prominent on the SERP itself. Event schema, not necessarily appropriate for this page. Local business, again, not necessary for this page. Recipe, FAQ page, course, product. So we got pretty much everything. Social media profiles, they do have some social media down here in the footer, so they should be using that as well. So it did a pretty good job of giving you all of the basics. Now, if you're still looking at this and you're like, Todd, what am I even looking at? Google did create a tool. Now, it doesn't go over all of the different properties and types that you can add to a website, but it gives you a fairly good entry point into creating schema types. So, you know, if you're taking a look at a blog post or an article, you would just click that, you would go through your URL, or you could enter your HTML, and then you would start tagging, and you would just walk through this wizard, and it would provide you with the information that you need for your page. Now, you might be asking yourself, like, what is the point of applying all of this information to your website? Well, the cool thing is Google also provides a free testing tool called the Rich Results Test. And what it does is it shows you which schema types are available to be shown on the SERP itself. So we can see that there are 5 valid items detected. There are product snippets, merchant listings, and review snippets. And then the great part about this is, and when you're going to do this yourself, you can either select desktop or mobile. I've selected mobile. You can preview what it's being shown. So you can see that if The Ordinary was showing breadcrumb snippets, schema, their breadcrumbs would be here. Instead, Google Webmasters is showing their own, but that would be there. We have our ratings. So that is pulling from the structured data that is relevant from that section. You know, this probably isn't the best one, you know, a 3. I did take a look at the rest of the website, and they do have some well-regarded products, but this one isn't, with 2 actual reviews, and is for $15. So again, this is where the price range is coming from, and then a little bit more information about it. But let's just hop back. Oh, of course it kicked me out. But let's just simply do this again. And I'm going to cut here and then redo this. All right, guys, we're back. And I'm glad I cut there, because it actually took about 4 minutes to load, and I'm not entirely sure why. But the reason that we use the rich results test in addition to the schema markup validator is they show different issues and errors. And we can see here on the page, the product snippets, the merchant listings, they have non-critical issues detected. And if we drill down into it, we can kind of see what it is. And in this case, it's a missing field, and the price valid until it is optional. It's not going to stop you from appearing in the SERP with all of your structured data. as we've seen with the actual SERP preview, Google is showing it. It shows our star ratings. It would show our breadcrumb listings. It would show our pricing tag. So me personally, I would just leave it alone as is. But if you really wanted to get rid of the issue, you could just set your price valid until to 1 year in advance and then programmatically set it to just update as you get closer to that 1 year. So you'll constantly be 1 year out. Now, again, I would just leave it alone because Google doesn't see it as being a true issue. And so it's still showing up on the SERP. Now, guys, that's exactly how I would audit this page. And that's how I would audit all of the structured data for a smaller website. If you're trying to do this at scale, again, I would use a third-party tool like Screaming Frog or an Ahrefs if you have it available to you. But this is a perfectly suitable way to do a smaller, maybe a medium-sized website, because if you're taking a look at one page, you can kind of get an idea that it's going to be across the board of all the product pages. And then once you do that, take a look at the collections page. What happens on the home page? Is there blog posts? Do they have structured data on them? How about the about page? Contact page. So you'll get an idea and a feel for what a website actually has going for it. But that's how you audit schema markup. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you learned something. If you did, hit the thumbs up. If you didn't, hit the thumbs up anyway. I'd really appreciate it. Subscribe. I put a whole bunch of free stuff in the description below. And until next time, I'm Todd, and take care.